The first night of freedom for the woman once described as Australia's worst female serial killer, Kathleen Folbigg. It has taken multiple inquiries and new scientific evidence to see Folbigg pardoned over the deaths of her four children. Joining us now is Dr. Emma Cunliffe, a law professor and the author of a book about Kathleen Folbigg's 2003 conviction, Murder, Medicine and Motherhood. Thank you for being here. Firstly, what were some of the problems that you saw within the trial?
Hi, Ashley. Thank you for having me here today. The 2003 trial had a number of flaws in it. As at 2003, a significant problem was that the medical evidence that the jury heard was incomplete and misleading about the state of medical understanding of repeat unexplained infant death in a single family. So the jury heard that natural deaths hadn't been documented in the medical literature, that repeat deaths were likely, if not conclusively, murder. And those ideas weren't well challenged within the trial. Secondly, the jury heard largely uncontested lay interpretations of the diaries kept by Kathleen Folbigg during her children's lives, and nobody looked for expert evidence to understand how a mother who'd experienced repeat infant death might experience repeated bereavement or might articulate feelings of self-blame and of guilt as a result of her experiences.
So you're saying that Folbigg was essentially convicted on the basis that the deaths of four children had to be murder?
That was a large part of the Crown case, yes.
God, it's... Do you think that... What kind of a change do we need to see? I mean, her diary evidence that we saw, should that have even been included in your view?
I think it's a long-standing principle of the common law that something that an accused person has written that might be relevant to the crimes is always admissible without evaluating its reliability or the risks associated with it. That's a rule that needs to be re-evaluated, the question of how best to put evidence of that kind before the jury with the context that will help them to consider alternative interpretations is something that's really raised by this case.
The head of this latest inquiry said he couldn't find any evidence that Folbigg was anything other than a caring mother. How did it all go so wrong for her?
That's a great question, Ursula. Kathleen was tried at a time when there was a medical dogma that repeat unexplained infant deaths in one family had to be murder unless proven otherwise. And ironically, also at a time when we understood far less about the genetic causes of sudden infant death than we do today. I think hearing that evidence really paved the way to a great deal of ambiguous evidence about the quality of Kathleen Folbigg's mothering being used to paint her as a woman who was capable of murdering her children and of getting away with it. And that evidence wasn't really critically evaluated in 2003 at her trial, but it has now been critically evaluated by Commissioner Bathurst.
What does this mean for other cases now? Do we need to see an overhaul of the way that these cases specifically are run?
Absolutely. I think there's two striking things that we can say. The first is that at about the same time in England, a series of cases were also run on a similar premise. And those convictions were identified as wrongful convictions and corrected within a year or two. Whereas in New South Wales, Kathleen Folbigg's case has taken 20 years to address. The difference between the two systems is that in England, there's an independent criminal cases review commission who's tasked with looking at the reliability of evidence in convictions, and they acted very quickly. The second question that should always be asked when a wrongful conviction has arisen is whether there are any similarities between the kinds of evidence that went wrong in a case like this and other cases that may still be working their way through the system. And presently in New South Wales, no one's tasked with looking systematically at other cases to make sure that other concerns don't arise.
It's very interesting. A lot more to run on this story. Thank you, Doctor, for your time today.
Thank you, Ursula.